it looks like the only sure way of getting those silo doors to open is by launching the rocket.
Thank you.
Did that. All done. Check. All done. I haven't done that. I haven't done that. Feel like talking?
I don't feel like talking anymore.
We're trapped down here. Get a ladder or something.
Oh, Matt, I've been so worried about you. Where have you been? I missed you so much. I was afraid I'd never see you again. And I've got so much to tell you. No, I take that back. There's only one thing I want to tell you. I love you. Do you hear me? I love you.
By the time Kit came back with a ladder, Kyler had said I love you to Matt approximately 150 times. And Matt had said it to Kyler about 200 times, and they were still saying it to each other on the day of their wedding 4 days later. Even Kit remarked that Matt's little misadventure seemed to have been good for their relationship. Needless to say, this bummed kid out. Until he met the very beautiful young Irish woman who catered the reception. Long story short, it looks like Kit will soon be returning to Ireland, and not just to sketch plans for potential housing developments. As for Mr. Delaney, he still can't accept the fact that the strange wail I kept hearing wasn't a banshee, but an old siren that Matt kept inadvertently setting off down in the tunnels. Nor is he clear on the fact that Fiona, whose jetpack was also a source of weird noises, was responsible for many of the strange phenomena he'd always attributed to fairies. But he understood immediately that Fiona was someone in need of compassion and helped the police take her into custody without incident. Apparently, after the explosion killed her parents, Fiona was taken in and raised by an old hermit who lived alone in the bog hut, which did not exactly do wonders for the little girl's mental or emotional development. But she's getting lots of attention now, and she's so bright, after all, her father was a rocket scientist, that her prognosis is actually pretty good. Me, I'm on my way back to the States, via jet plane, not jet pack. My pack and Fiona's were quickly confiscated by military types bent on adapting them for use on the battlefield. Unfortunately for them, Brendan's intricate fuel system has him completely and hopelessly stumped, which has no doubt made Fiona's crow and all its feathered friends very happy. They finally have the skies above Castle Malloy all to themselves. When my best friend Bess Marvin wins a vacation for three at a resort on a private island in the Bahamas, she naturally invites me and her cousin George Fane to go with her. But by the time I arrive, the owners of the resort are nowhere to be found, and Bess has been kidnapped. To get her back, George and I must find a long-lost treasure, a quest that brings us face-to-face with many of the island's strange inhabitants, and forces us to risk our lives, both on and in the sea. Help us find the treasure before this sun-drenched paradise turns deadly. In my next adventure, Ransom of the Seven Ships.